So the first thing we're going to do, you're probably going to want to sum the amounts in this table, right? I mean, what good is a list of transactions without a total? Usually you want to see what's going on. So the first thing that you do is you press Control A. What that does, that selects the entire contiguous area. So as long as there's no gaps, it's going to spread out until this table stops. And then once you have the whole table selected, this one's good. This one's a magical one if you haven't seen this one. You can do Alt equals, and that's going to sum every column that has numbers in it. You can see them appear down, see the totals appear down at the bottom. So now you have your table of data, but it looks a little crowded. So you think you want to add a few rows at the top. Start at the top, hold down the Shift key and press the space bar. That will select an entire row. And while you're still holding down the Shift key, if you want additional rows, press a down arrow. So after you've selected these two rows that you see on the screen, we want to add in a few blank rows above them. So you do that by pressing in the right click key, which is to the right of the Alt, typically on a keyboard. If you bought a Windows machine, it'll have that shortcut key on it. You press that, or you right click your mouse to get the right click menu, and then you can type an I to go to insert. And there you are. You have two blank rows at the top. You can now type a header, or you can just have a little extra room there. Okay, now we want to get rid of some of the columns that are in here. This data, the names may have been important at some point in time, but for what you're doing, let's act like we don't want them. So hold down the Control key and press the space bar. That'll select an entire column. And then while you're still holding down the Control key, hit your left arrow. That'll do the column and the column left of it. Once you have it selected, hit the right Windows key, which is to the right of the Alt key, and then D for delete. If you're preparing this for someone who doesn't want to see the decimal places, or if you don't want to see the decimal places, that's an easy fix, and you don't have to use your mouse for that either. You can start out by holding down the Control key and pressing the space bar to select the columns. Holding the Control key and the space bar still, press the right arrow to select both of these columns that you're looking at. Now to get up to the ribbon, hit your Alt key, which activates the ribbon, H to say you want to use the home ribbon, and then 9 to decrease the decimal. I'm going to do it one more time. It'll get rid of both decimals.